Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. So I am here today to do a review of the Clever Fox Planner. So Clever Fox reached out to me and asked if I would like to be sent a planner to review for their company. And of course I agreed because I love planning, I love planners, and I love doing reviews of different kinds of planners. So this is a hardbound black planner. They do have several color options. I will put their Amazon store in my description box down below. They didn't have purple though, so I was a little disappointed about that. These are very reasonably priced. So without further ado, here is my review of the Clever Fox Planner. It came in this nice box here. Give you a little bit of ASMR feels. And it has a nice little fox logo on there for the Clever Fox brand. And I will put their Amazon information down below. So it did come with some coupon codes. I first opened up the box. You get these planner stickers here, and you get about, let's see, is that three or four sheets? You get three sheets of these functional planner stickers. So it looks like you have maybe prayer or meditation or self-care, a reading or studying sticker, heart maybe for your health, budgeting, meal planning maybe, exercising, presents, gifts, or birthdays type sticker. This may be a birthday sticker as well. Looks like they're wearing hats, like a kid's party. You have a family sticker, and then this can just be like a productivity sticker at the top. So that's pretty cool, and they're color coordinated, and you get three sheets of that. Next, you get this guide that says how to use this planner, and it gives you step by step of what you can do. I believe from the looks of this planner, it has different prompts, meaning you can put, you know, what you're grateful for, your daily rituals, things like that. Step one says, be grateful for what you have. Think about what you love to do and learn new habits and skills. Step two says, create a vision for your life. Step three, set your goals. Step four, choose your five most important one-year goals and break them down. So I think that's really awesome. Step five says, use monthly and weekly layouts to incorporate your goals into your daily agenda. So it gives you an example of what the monthly layout looks like and the weekly layout looks like. And then it even, you know, if you look at it further, it shows you what exactly you can put down. And it gives you step by step for each of those too. So if you're someone definitely new to planning and you're not quite sure what to track in your planner, I think this may be a good start for you. But the real test will come when we open up the planner and see for ourselves. When the company reached out to me, they did ask me which color I prefer. And I asked for purple at the time, and if they didn't have purple, to choose black. So they did send me black. They don't have purple as an option, but they do have pink and orange, and I believe like a royal blue color. Like I said, I'll put the link down below for you to check it out. Now, the Clever Fox Planner is a non-dated weekly planner. It says achieve your goals and increase your productivity, passion, and happiness. It says productivity, passion, motivation, happiness, and focus. On the back, it says by using Clever Fox Planner, you can stay focused on your goals, develop good habits, feel happier, increase your productivity, live a more fulfilling life. So it says that it includes a monthly review, weekly review, goals, habit tracker, one-year weekly planner layout, affirmations, gratitude, and inspiration. So it seems to have everything that you would want or need in a plan. It does come with this nice elastic to keep it secure, and you have a nice little pin loop. And I love when planners automatically come with the pin loops so you don't have to buy any extra accessories, even though we all love our accessories. And I definitely think this will be great in a professional setting. If you're someone that does not like to make the elaborate layouts, if you're strictly a pen and paper type of planner, I think so far, I haven't opened it up yet, I think this will be great for you. All right, it says designed in Europe, crafted with care in China, 100% recycled paper. And on the front, it does have the Clever Fox Planner. It has where you can put your name and contact information. And it says your reward. I guess your reward if you turn in this planner to that person. I don't know who would necessarily do all that. But if you have some sensitive information in there, you may want to put, you know, a reward or something. So when you turn after that, you get a gratitude page. It says my gratitude and self-awareness I'm grateful for. And you get some lines here to type or to write what you're grateful for. You get what am I passionate about? What brings me joy in life? On the next page, it says my daily rituals, skills to learn, and habits to adopt this year. So that, again, we get the prompts I was telling you about. If you're not sure what to put in your planner and you just feel like you should be doing more, or you feel like you need more as far as your self-awareness and gratitude, then these are prompts that kind of motivate you to write in it. And down here it has my affirmations, so you could put down some positive affirmations that maybe you want to recite to yourself. And then here you get my vision board. You get two blank pages for that. And not quite sure if a lot of you are familiar with what a vision board is, but it's pretty much, usually it's a cardboard or a poster board, and you put down images or words or phrases, inspirational things, a vision, so to speak, of how you want the next year of your life to go, the next 6 months, and so on and so forth. So right here in the planner, they're giving you the space to write down your vision in the planner instead of using a poster board. So you have plenty of space to do that. And then you can achieve that, honestly, by doing a little bit of bullet journaling and, you know, putting in some images and things like that. The next section says my goals, and it has these sections that say life areas. So you have different life areas, and then on the side of that, to the right hand side, it says my top goals for this year. So you have a health section, business, career, family and friends, significant other and romance, finance, personal development, fun and recreation, and spiritual. So I love that it has these very descriptive categories, especially the significant other in romance, because oftentimes we just put that in our personal category. And, you know, personal can be your health and your family and friends, fun and spiritual, you know, all those things fall under personal. But I love how they break it down and you get all these different things, especially the personal development. I think that's great going into the new year. Next, you have my focus. So what are your top five goals for the year, I'm guessing? And the mind map, you know, it says my mind map, not to be confused with the vision board. You know, it could be a map of how you plan to achieve those five goals. But in the same breath, that could be a reflection of your vision board as well. So I like that in the planner. And then here we see, guessing, is this the monthly? Let me take a look here. Okay, so it looks like you get your month in front of the weeks. So that, for me, honestly, that setup of it is a little weird, because you have to, this is your first month, say this is January, but then you have to flip quite a ways back here to get to the week of January. But at the same time, I guess that's where these come into play, these page markers. So that's why they have three of them there. So you can put one for your weekly, and then you could put one for your monthly. And then if you want to put one at the front by the vision board or the mind map, you can. So at least they do give you these ribbon bookmarkers or page markers. So here's what the monthly layout looks like. It says month and year. So you, like I said, it's undated. So you would go through and date it yourself, put your month and year up there, and then put the actual dates of the days. It says your plan, habits to adopt, skills to learn, things to avoid. That's very important. Places to go, people to see. And it says this month's goals, this month's wins, and how I'll improve next month. So I love how, again, it gives you those prompts and things to, you know, keep your mind on for that month. And then next here, this is your weekly layout. So it is a horizontal weekly layout. It gives you about, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, technically about 4 lines. Again, you do have to go through and put in the dates. And on the other side of that, you get this like dashboard layout, and it says this week's main goal, and then it says here, reward if you achieve. So it's pretty much telling you to reward yourself if you achieve your main goal for that week. And there's a spot to put down the reward for yourself. Next, you have this week's priorities. You get a little bullet journaling section that says notes, personal to-do list, habits and skills that you want to keep up with. And there's a check mark for each day, or a circle, bullet, whatever, for each day. You can mark down if you've kept up with that habit or skill. This week's wins and how I'll improve next week. So that is awesome. So we went over the monthly and the weekly layout. Let's go back here to to the back of the planner. And on the back of the planner, my goodness, you get quite a bit of pages. It looks like the rest of the planner, actually. So that's easily, to be honest with you, that's probably about 80 pages that you get worth of, dot grid paper. And this is great, again, for bullet journaling, or, again, if you want to map out, you know, what you see your life being like in 2019. Of course, we may have all the plans, but, you know, life doesn't necessarily go as planned. But you do have things to take notes if you're out and about, if you're a student, if you need, you know, you don't have a notebook with you, you have all this dot grid paper to take those notes and things of that nature. And on the back, what is this on the back? How about that? Now, you see this a lot in Kate Spade planners and journals and notebooks, but here's a little folder section for you to maybe put coupons or receipts, anything that you need to put back there. So I think that's very awesome, and that is built into the planner. My overall review, or my overall opinion about this planner, is that, again, I think it is great for someone that needs a little direction as far as their planning is concerned, because again, it gives you prompts and, you know, ideas of things that you can keep track of in your planner. And this is great for someone that is very much so a minimalist. They don't need the stickers, they don't need the washi, they don't need any of that. All they need is a pen and their planner. It'll fit great in a purse. It's not too heavy. It's very professional looking. You don't necessarily need these ribbon things. If you want to cut these out because you don't like the colors that they're in, you could cut them out. Do whatever you want to do. But I think this is great for a professional setting for sure. Well, that is my intensive review of the Clever Fox Planner. I hope that you all have enjoyed. Please don't forget to check them out. Their information will be listed down below. I hope that y'all are having a great day, and I will talk to you again in my next video. Bye.